first of all, let me just start by thanking Jeff for his leadership at Vertex and his leadership in the space and his commitment to the Commonwealth. He mentioned in passing our digital health initiative. What he didn't mention is that he actually chairs it. And as a state that has tremendous assets in the healthcare and technology space, we view this digital health opportunity not just as a chance for us to be a global leader in what I consider to be the first inning of a very long game with respect to how we use data and information to improve the quality of healthcare, but I also view it as a way to dramatically improve the quality of healthcare that people receive generally. And there have been plenty of studies that have been done that point out over and over again that in many cases, better information at the point in time in which people make decisions can dramatically improve the quality of the care that's provided to people who are battling and dealing with illness. The other thing I noticed during that video about Vertex, I'm a Republican governor in Massachusetts, which is a pretty blue state, and I just really appreciate the fact that Vertex's corporate colors are purple. I also want to thank Jim Greenwood for his 10 years of leadership on behalf of the bio community generally. There's no question that the work that he and his team have done and that all of you have done have dramatically raised the visibility and the footprint of this critically important industry, not just in the Commonwealth of Mass or here in California, but across the country and around the world. And Jim, you deserve enormous credit for your leadership on that one. And I know you're going to hear shortly from Ann Romney, who spent a good part of her adult life living in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And she's here today to talk about the center that she established at Brigham and Women's Hospital to deal with neurological diseases. And Ann is a remarkable person. She has faced MS with a tremendous amount of courage, but the work in particular that's being done by this institute that she established at the Brigham and Women's Hospital, which brings together people from a whole variety of different disciplines, who in many cases are sharing an opportunity for the first time to tackle some of the toughest problems we face in science, is really a wonderful example of somebody finding something positive out of something negative and choosing to invest in it in a significant way. And I'm certainly looking forward to hearing what she has to say as well. I also want to say thank you to San Diego and to California for hosting this year. This has been a wonderful experience for us and for our team and for all the folks from Massachusetts who are out here. I do want to say that we're all looking forward to having you come to Boston and to Massachusetts next year. 22,000 people came to Bio in Massachusetts when we last hosted it. It's really important to me that it be 22,001. In 2018, so I really appreciate it if y'all could sign up and make your bookings early so that we can exceed the goal from the last year. Now, with respect to Massachusetts generally, the old joke is that if you create two great research institutions and then wait a couple of hundred years, really good things happen. And while that certainly has something to do with the success of the Commonwealth, I would also argue that the ecosystem that Jeff spoke about developed over the course of a very long time for a whole bunch of reasons, some of which involved the private sector, but some of which also involved the public sector. And I would talk quickly about two with respect to the public sector. The first was, in the 1990s, Massachusetts made a decision to invest heavily both in improving the quality of our public schools, but also fixing some of the issues we had with our funding formula. And that investment, in both raising the standards and raising the bar with respect to what we wanted with regard to K-12 education and the decision to change the way we financed education, over the course of 25 years or so has really borne significant fruit. And even though Massachusetts was always a state that had a very rich history in education, if you actually look where we landed in most of the national assessment education exams, we were always somewhere right in the middle in the 1990s, but after we put in the curriculum frameworks and the assessment requirements and changed the funding formula, and I was on the state's Board of Education when we did all this, you could watch year over year after year as Massachusetts' numbers started to rise. And for the last 6 years in a row, Massachusetts has been the number one performer in the country in both math and English. We're the only state that's ever done that, and we've done it for 6 years in a row. And that has certainly dramatically improved the quality of the opportunity for kids coming out of the Massachusetts public school system and heading on to higher education or to whatever came next for them. The second thing we did was developed, again, on a bipartisan basis, a very successful initiative around life sciences, which led to a significant investment, especially in the education space, to improve the quality of our, what I would describe as our capacity to provide support for people who are interested in STEM careers and in life sciences and in biotechnology. And that, in many respects, has been a tremendous asset to the companies and to the innovators and to others who have chosen to come to Massachusetts, to come to Boston, to grow their businesses. And with respect to that, I just want to say here today that one of the things we did earlier this week was we announced the filing of what I would call the next act on our investment in our Life Science Center, which is a five-year, $500 million commitment to invest in that Life Science Center and the programming that it offers. Now, there will be several pieces to this. A big part of it's going to be around workforce development, because even though we are a very significant player in the STEM education space, one of the big messages we hear over and over again from folks like you is that we need to do more with respect to the pipeline. We need more folks coming into the field, more folks in the workforce development area, and that's going to end up being a major place where I believe we'll create public-private partnerships going forward. We'll also be able to make public-private partnership investments in a whole variety of research endeavors. That's something that we can partner with our colleagues in the research community, the education space, the healthcare community, the technology space, and in the private sector to chase interesting ideas where we can serve as what I would describe as sort of the stitching that makes the program work. And the final thing I'd say about that is, for us, as a state where 20 of the largest 20 medical device companies in the world have significant presence in Massachusetts, where 18 of the most significant pharma and biotech companies have a presence, and where we have a very robust intellectual ecosystem, the opportunity for us to continue to partner and to invest side by side with so many of the world's biggest brains in this space is a tremendous opportunity for us. And while yes, it's important for us to create jobs, while yes, it's important for us to be a leader in inquiry and discovery, and by the way, we are working with a number of other governors and a whole variety of research institutions, colleges and universities, and healthcare organizations, and folks in the biopharma community to make sure that we continue to invest as a nation in science and technology and big ideas going forward. One of the things we should always remember, and several folks talked about it here, is in the end, this is about diagnostics, therapies, and cures, helping people who are dealing with terrible problems find a way, find hope and possibility with respect to whatever their particular issue might be. And I've been shaving my head every year. By the way, it's not my normal haircut. I've been shaving my head every year for the past few years to raise money for Dana-Farber, and which is one of the world's leading cancer research and cancer service organizations. And Dana-Farber is a great place. And all of us have shaved our heads for the past few years for them. I managed to raise about $14 or $15 million to support research there. But a big part of what's interesting to me about this is I go and visit folks there and talk to them about what they're doing and talk to patients. I've talked to a lot of folks there who said, I've been here for 20 years, I've been here for 30 years, I've been here for 15 years. The advancement in science over that period of time has taken what used to be, in many cases, sort of, we'll try a whole bunch of things and see if something works. And in some cases it will, but in many it won't. And got to the point where people literally, when folks come in and present with a set of symptoms that turn into a diagnosis, they can say to people, you know what, based on what we know, what we've learned, and how we can move forward on this, we believe you have a very good chance of being successfully treated and cured with respect to what your illness is. Now, politics and public life tends to be something that goes by in a Twitter feed, but if you look at sort of the arc of inquiry and discovery, especially in in biotechnology over the course of the past 20 or 30 years. You know, every 10 years or so, the game changes dramatically. And while that's not something that gets noticed because it takes place over such a long period of time by people who are just paying attention to what happened today, yesterday, and tomorrow, for those of you who are in this space, for those of you who play and participate in chasing therapies and cures and possibilities here, it makes an enormous difference to the folks who are living with these illnesses and these diseases every single day. And I just want to thank you for the work you do on that, because I end up, both from my time in the healthcare world before I get into government, but also as a father of three kids who has plenty of friends whose kids and whose brothers and sisters and moms and dads have gotten sick over the course of my lifetime, watching our ability, your ability collectively, to provide people with possibility, hope, and solutions in situations and circumstances where there were none for a very long period of time is simply breathtaking. And I know I speak on behalf of all the folks associated with my administration, the folks associated with Boston Mayor Marty Walsh, his administration, some of the folks of whom are here today. We are really looking forward to having you all come to Boston next year, come to Massachusetts, have a chance to experience what I consider to be one of the truly great ecosystems in bio you're going to find anywhere on planet Earth, and to talk about all the great work that you and your colleagues and others are up to, solving problems, curing diseases, providing people with therapies, and giving people hope. Thank you very much.